your 11 Inch to Weather Plus forecast with meteorologist John Collins.
Well, yesterday there were a lot of clouds in the area. Temperatures were in the 70s, and a cold front was coming through. There were a few scattered showers with that front, but when the front went through, the temperatures dropped dramatically. And now, today, we have clouds in the area. The temperatures aren't all that warm, and we only have a couple of sprinkles out in the mountains to the west. That's what's showing up right now. And it looks like clouds will be a big feature of our weekend coming up. I'll have that forecast in just a second. But let's take a look at what happened during the day today. It started out rather chilly. 45 was the low at the airport and 53 at the Inner Harbor. 58 is typical and 41 was the record. So we didn't tie or break the record, but you needed a sweater this morning. 65 the high at the airport. Typical is 78. 68 was the high at the Inner Harbor. And it looks like we'll hold on to these readings for a while. What's in green on the map are temperatures generally in the 60s around the area, although we're beginning to see that kind of a green-blue shade. Temperatures 61 Parkton and Westminster. Readings are beginning to fall into the 50s off to our northwest. Salisbury is 66 right now, and it's only 50 at Oakland and 52 at Frostburg at this stage of the game. So we're just kind of set up for more chilly temperatures out there. Satellite image shows the scattered clouds that we've had all day long. It's a thin cloud deck, so the sun tried to bleed through from time to time, but there was just too much there. We couldn't warm up because of that very much. And we also have these north winds coming off this big area of high pressure. So the combination of the two things held the temperatures down. It was rather cool to chilly during the day today. The front that went through yesterday is now off the Carolina coast. A little storm will develop along that front, or a little wave, a low pressure center, and get close to us, toss some clouds our way, or actually reinforce the clouds that we have, make them lower and thicker. And somebody's going to get some rain over the weekend. It looks like it'll be south of Baltimore, but we'll be watching the storm development to the south of us over the weekend. Look at the temperatures nationwide. That huge area of high pressures really brought in an invasion of Canadian air, cool, dry air, covering most of the eastern two-thirds of the country except the Gulf Coast region. Still rather warm in Texas, where it's up around 90 in the Dallas-Fort Worth area right now, and into the desert southwest, of course. Our forecast tonight, the clouds persist. There'll be some breaks in the clouds here and there. No rain. Chilly, though. 47 to 53. Not quite as chilly as yesterday morning, or this morning rather, but close. Light and variable winds. We're not headed for any records, though, as far as lows are concerned. Mostly cloudy tomorrow. Cool again. And maybe a shower south of us, like south of Annapolis. 66 to 70, the high tomorrow. Similar to today, maybe a degree or two warmer. Way off the normal, though. Northeast winds at 5 to 10 miles an hour. InstaWeather Futurecast shows this little storm developing and some showers getting close to us from time to time. Saturday into at least early Sunday, and then Monday a little drier, maybe a little more sun bleeding through, but a storm threatening to the west. Football game, Nashville on Sunday afternoon, mostly cloudy skies, maybe a thunderstorm. It's only a small chance. 77 to 82 game time temperatures. Here's our forecast. 68 tomorrow and 69 on Sunday, so stays cool. Showers to the south, they'll be scattered. Mostly cloudy skies, rain chances kick in really midweek next week, and will be with us on again, off again, most of next week.